budget guidelines for our respective research budgets. May you guide us through this throughout this session and for the rest of the day. This we ask in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Okay, welcome po sa ating first webinar, and kung napapansin niyo po, nandiyan po sa poster po natin, this will be an orientation and workshop on research grant financial management as per the experience of the National Catechetical Study 2021 PARI project. And so to formally welcome everyone sa ating first webinar series, I am so pleased na pumunta sa UST si Dr. De Castro para po bigyan lang po tayo ng opening remarks today. So I am so happy to introduce virtually ang ating director ng RCSED na kailangan natin pakisamahan ngayon kasi inaayos na niya yung load natin. Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome Dr. Belinda De Castro, PhD. Hi, ma'am.
Hello, good morning to each and every one. It's nice to see each and every one of you today. After a long period of quarantine, ang ganda ng mga backgrounds ninyo. Ako office pa rin. Okay, allow me to read what I have read kasi with so many things running in my mind, I might forget to really say what I would like to say. So I hope all of you and your families are safe and healthy during this quarantine period. We have been actually in quarantine for 3 months now, and it's feels great actually to see you once again. Welcome to this webinar series, wherein you will be expecting more of this within the academic year. But first of all, I would like to thank, this is courtesy of the NCS group. So it's actually through the kindness of the lead proponent, of course, Dr. Yayat Batan, and also through Ms. Ruth, no? Through their kindness, they accepted the challenge now to have the first webinar. And I just felt that it is actually the opportune time for us to meet for something like this on financial management, how to actually manage our funds, no? Whether it be an external grant or simply our university funding. I would like, of course, I might not have the privilege of talking again later, so I would like to thank, of course, Sir Yayat and Ms. Ruth for this webinar series, no? for accepting the first one of this webinar series. So expect that we will have more of this throughout the year, simply because this is a way for us to really meet once in a while and at the same time be connected, no? Para ma-feel nyo na we are still in RCSED. So kaya lang kami ni Sir Yayat, we really have to go to UST pa para lang ma-meet kayo, no, through this webinar. So let me just check. Okay, so I think we're good at this time, and I'm so happy that many joined the webinar for today, and I hope we can make use of whatever we are going to learn for today. So sit still and listen and participate actively in the discussion. So without further ado, let me turn you over again to Sir Yayat. Thank you so much for coming. Sir Yayat, thank you.
Ganun yung palakpak natin. pagkaano. Thank you so much, Doc Bell, and thank you for this opportunity. Matagal na po natin na pag-usapan to for a number of ano, for a number of months or since last year pa po ito. So, before getting into the presentation per se, I just would like to share with you some of the rationale of our orientation today. So technically, yung overview po natin, I hope you could see it online, no? So what we wanted to really achieve is to just give you an overview of how a grant is being managed financially. So this is mainly the experience of the NCS 2021 PARI project. First year pa lang po yung implementation, pero marami na po kaming natutunan. And so, may tatlo po itong bahagi. Ang unang bahagi lang po is, firstly, yung struggle namin pag-develop ng grant budget guidelines. So, UST has all the policies, no? Pero yung mga guidelines kasi, meron tayo sa RCZ, meron sa OVRI, meron sa Treasurer's Office. Medyo nalilito kami, so we would have to develop our own budget guidelines within the policy. So yun po yung unang problematic po namin. Pangalawa po is to show you how we manage really our finances over the number of months. I think we spent around 4 million in the last few months. And so this is something na medyo ano po, gusto namin i-share. And the last one will be a workshop. But it's not a workshop na kasama po kayo. It's just a workshop showing you through Excel how we balance our finances through the courtesy of Ms. Ruth. So generally, the aim really is to provide a space for us, yung admin, managers, researchers, grant recipients, and especially our assistants who are always tasked to present and you know, produce liquidation reports. And later, makikita nyo po na siguro may makikita kayong mga ideas na dapat ganito pala, hindi pala liquidation report lang. Kasi pag liquidation report lang ang gagawin, talagang hindi nyo makikita yung kabuuan ng pond. And so we wanted to really to raise the general issues and concerns of financial management of the grant in our respective projects. Okay, so our flow will be simple. We will have grant budget guidelines, finance management system, and then we will have some kind of workshop using MMXL. Workshop in a sense na papakita lang po sa inyo ni Ms. Ruth kung paano po namin binabalanse ang aming mga project, right? And so we will have an open discussion. So okay po kami sa ano sa mga questions po ninyo. But before that, I stumbled into this sa ano po sa ano natin sa Facebook. Hindi po ako to, pero mamaya po, wala po kasi Google Meet po kasi walang ano, walang raise hand, right? O mamaya po, yan po yung gesture po natin kung if you have a question. And then, pag kami nag-chat-chat po, kunyari, meron kayong chinat sa akin, hindi ko kayo pinapansin, medyo tumuro lang po kayo ng ano, ng sa baba. That means, check the chat. And then, if it's okay, just give an okay sign. And then, if you can't hear me because I muted myself, and then, so ita ko ng salita, pero mute ko pala, pwede po kayo mag-sign po na, you know, pointing to your ears. And then, yan, pag kunyari naririnig ko po yung mga kaliskis o ano yung mga kaluskos kaliskis kaluskos ng ano ng mga kung ano diyan nangyayari sa bahay, para pwede po yan. Focus on me means na pagka meron pong ine-emphasize, and then pagtapos na po we could have a, you know, that series, yung po siya. So without further ado, I will stop presenting because I'm going to turn this over to my and our project assistant. I would just like to introduce her informally kasi we have been working many years. I've known our main presenter today for a number of years. Pareho po kaming lumaki sa Binangonan. Doon po siya sa malayong barangay. Ako po ay nasa Poblacion. But we were batchmates sa Binangonan Catholic high school dati, ngayon college na po siya. So interestingly, for many years, so dito rin po siya nag-aral ng accountancy dito sa University of Santo Tomas. I would not say kung kailan, pero mukhang mga kabatch po siya ng mga kuya ko. So medyo mas patanda po siya sa akin. And so she started her career sa China Bank for a number of years, and so naging teller, and marami po siya mga perang nabilang. Hindi lang po napa sa kanya, pero ito po ay kanya pong nabilang, mga million-million rin po ito. And then well, just like many of your stories, she fell in love, and when she fell in love, yun po, pumunta po siya ng Saudi kasama ang mahal niya, and doon na po siya nagtrabaho. Sa pagtatrabaho niya sa Saudi, dito po niya nakita yung financial system management sa school, na kaya nung nadito po siya sa atin, nung nakita ko po siya dito, bumalik po siya dahil dito na po mag-aaral yung mga anak niya. Kinausap ko siya, and I was really surprised that she has all those skills na mukhang kailangan ng center natin. And so when there was this chance, I offered a job na sana maging finance officer po namin siya. However, other than pagiging finance officer, ginawa po namin siyang admin. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm so pleased to introduce to you our project assistant for admin and finance. We have Miss Ruth De Leon Andaya from Binangonan Rizal. So Ruth, take it away.
Get away. Thank you po, Doc Yahit.
Oh, ganda niya, Terut.
Sinabihan ako ni Doc Yahit, kailangan akong maligo. Okay. Good morning po, everyone. Okay. Mag-start na po tayo ngayon sa ating presentation. Welcome, everyone, to this presentation about orientation and workshop on research grant financial management. Okay po ba ang boses ko? Narinig po ba? I am Miss Ruth Andaya, yours truly po, from NCS Fire Project. From the orientation, you will see the journey of NCS 2021 project on its inception year. You will understand the importance po ng budget of guidelines in connection to the proposed line item budget in procedures namin, natin, documentation, using the Excel worksheet in monitoring the expenses, liquidations, and audited financial report. Ang aim po natin ay mag-provide ng space sa research stakeholders to discuss the general issues, ano po yung mga challenges ng grant financial management and experience ng NCS Power Project. To start our the part one of our presentation, let me show you an example of a simple personal budget template. Do we have our own
Miss Ruth?
Sorry. We have our own system in management, managing our funds. Ito pong sa slide na to, you can see the amount of salary, the expenses, as well as the percentage sa budget natin. So, dito maki-clearly emphasize kung ano ang significance po ba ng budget planning sa personal level natin, sa business, and especially dito sa ating grant projects. So, dito sa research project natin, makikita natin that it is an activity-based project. Ang Porticus grant po was approved with an almost 11 million grant. We received our first tranche of 5.2 million last April 2019 with the requirement of submitting a Porticus or progress report before the transfer of the second tranche. Pero fortunately po, despite the difficulty ang situation natin ngayon, due to COVID pandemic situation natin, still we were able to receive the second tranche this April of 2020 po. So by the end of the contract, pagka na-implement na natin to, by the end of the second year, kailangan po natin mag-submit ng audited financial report sa issued by UST pag natapos na po yung project. So you will see the project activities naman po ng Porticus grant. It started from the conceptualization until intervention that is happening right now. So included po dito yung mga ibang operating expenses that is relevant to the implementation of the project. So showing you now is a glimpse of the NCS line item budget na pinapost po ni Doc Yayet and it was approved. So after the line item budget, Doc Yayet opted to create our own budget guidelines na tutulong sa atin to establish good control and management of the fund. So why is there a need for us to have these budget guidelines? First, to support the line item budget of NCS 2021 project, careful analysis of account qualification and procedures. Follow the NCS workflow chart na ginawa po namin, supported by valid quotations from UST suppliers. Ensure legitimacy of transaction that is relevant to the project. In liquidation report, with valid receipts and pertinent information, the simple and competent financial report that is ready for audit. Okay, papakita ko po ngayon ang ating budget guidelines.
Ms. Ruth, could you hear me?
Ms. Yes. Ruth?
Oo. Pwedeng i-click mo yung hide dun sa ilalim, yung staff
okay, share.
Ayan. Okay, good. Thank you.
Okay. Ito na po ang ating grant budget guidelines. It describes in detail the accounts na gagamitin natin sa lahat ng activities. Meron po siyang tinatawag nating pre-qualification system that will validate each transaction as part of the expense. Nandito po ang mga procedure to guide the team for proper workflow and implementation. Meron po itong mga templates na to be used for the documentation and approval. It shows also the reasonable allowances for fieldwork, the manner and timing of liquidation, reimbursement, and of course, the execution po na ating financial report. Yan po to. So I understand it will be shared to everyone po later. So sa part 2 naman po ng ating presentation, tapos na po yung careful preparation of our fund management system. So we use the appropriate templates in order to follow the NCS workflow. Yung approval system by each department. Ito, ipapakita ko po sa inyo ang mga templates na ginamit po natin. The activity request form, the RCZ request, purchase requisition, the equipment request, petty cash, and of course, the liquidation form. Using all those templates, depending on the nature of the transaction, we created our own workflow po. So from this, after allocation of the PA for admin and finance, ako po yun, i-approve po ito na ating principal investigator. So depending on the nature of the transaction, if it is an online requisition, it will be approved first by Doc Bell or the RCZ approval. So, and then sa purchasing po, and approved, we will be waiting for the approval of the finance from UST. So pag approved na ito, kailangan po tayo mag-submit ng at least 3 quotation, valid quotation from the UST suppliers And then, as part of the liquidation, kailangan natin makita yung PO, purchase order, and the proof of delivery ng product. Okay? And while if the request will come from cash advance, ako po naman ang mag-a-allocate again ng budget. And then it will be approved by Doc Yayet, and it should be liquidated with a valid official receipt. So ito na po yung kailangan religious nating susundin yung workflow ng natin. So after this process, we are now ready to submit our report. So lahat po tayo familiar sa first report na ipakikita ko. Ito po yung expense report natin as our liquidation report. So ito na po yun. Ito po yung UST template that we are required to use to liquidate our cash advance. So we will see if nagamit natin yung buong cash advance natin, if there's a deficit or a surplus. After that, nag-create po ako ng tinatawag nating summary of expenses na I consolidated all the cash advance. As of now, meron kaming at least 7 cash advances. So i-consolidate ko to, showing in total to monitor the allocated budget for each activity. So ang tanong ko lagi is, meron pa bang available fund for each activity? Kasi baka po ako ay sumobra na. So ito po yung example ng summary of cash advance na ginawa ko. So you will see that there's the line item budget based on the activity. Naka-itemize po dito kung ano ng mga first at mga cash advances namin, and compared with the line item budget to showing that there is a deficit, a surplus, or ongoing pa po yung budget, yung activity natin. Ngayon, dito po sa personal experience ko sa Saudi Arabia, papakita ko pa po muna pala, sorry, ang ating Porticus report. Ito po yung latest na sinubmit na namin last February of 2020. Ang coverage po niya is January 31, 2020. So dito po makikita natin containing the amount of the grant na natanggap natin, which is the 5.2 million, and the amount, the actual spending po natin. So indicating, of course, the percentage of budget usage, kasi interested po ang Porticus kung magkano ang nagastos natin coming from the 5.2 million of first tranche na receive natin. So gusto rin nilang malaman kung magkano po yung ending balance as of January, kung naggamit po ba natin yung buong tranche. So as I mentioned earlier, dun nga po sa personal experience ko sa Saudi Arabia, meron po akong kinreate na simple Excel worksheet para po makapag-establish po ako ng isang magandang report sa isang company na tinulungan ko po sa Saudi. So, ano po ba ang journal entry? It records all the transactions in an accounting book. So, later po, explain ko po ito sa inyo sa workshop. Next is the UST ledger. Let me show you, ito po yung coming from Hania ng accounting. So lagi po akong humihingi sa kanya ng ledger showing kung magkano po yung balance natin ngayon, running balance ng grant na na-receive natin. And then from the journal entry po na ginawa ko, there is this trial balance na nakalink po siya sa journal entry, which is the list of the ending balances of the general ledger account. So makikita na po natin dito yung mga accounts na kailangan natin na indicated po dyan sa budget guidelines. So ang end product po natin is the financial report. So from the trial balance, automatic na po siyang mapoproduce na magkakaroon po tayo ng financial report, which is the statement of operation for the grant and expenses. Dito po makikita yung amount ng grant and all the expenses together with the percentage na ng expenses natin versus the grant na na-receive natin. Dito makikita kung ano rin po, kung magkano po yung ending balance ng pera natin na na-deduct natin from the grant na na-receive. Okay? So, this ends the orientation part of our presentation. And shortly, I will be more than happy to show you the workshop for our simplified Excel worksheet ng NCS 2021 para project na ginamit kong financial tool in our reporting po.
Okay. Miss Ruth, ano muna? Pwede ba akong pumasok sa explanation? Okay lang. Oo. So kung mapapansin niyo po bago po tayo bago namin pakita kung paano namin ginawa ito sa Excel, malinaw na malinaw po na una napansin namin na may mga guidelines pero hindi malinaw yung fina-follow po namin, for example, yung sa atin sa OVRI, then sa RCSED. So medyo nalilito kami kasi we have to evolve our own templates para lahat ng kailangan namin ay okay. So yun yung unang point, yung pag-develop ng guidelines sa kahit ano bang project, kailangan meron, okay? And we would hope na yung templates, kasi meron na tayong generic template, pero merong minsan kailangan ng template para doon sa specific project kasi hindi po natin alam kung ano yung nature nung ginagawa nyo po. One of the things talaga na palaging issue natin ay yung paano mo ma-charge yung kinain mo sa sari-sari store o kaya sa ano. Ang hirap i-fathom, no? Yung mga ganung mga bagay-bagay na kailangan mo i-charge. So it ends up na marami tayong talagang naaabono. So yung mga templates na to, meron na po tayo nito, pwede po itong i-enhance, and ang wish ko lang is sana, you know, RCSED and OVRI, and more importantly, yung Office of the Treasurer, dapat maging malinaw talaga kung ano yung guideline nila sa mga bagay-bagay. So up to now, I have not seen a clear guideline the same way that we did it in the NCS, na lahat ng items na kailangan naming i-define, dinefine namin, okay? So that's number one. Number two is yung execution mismo nung pag-spend nung pera. Napaka-bureaucratic niya. One of the things na napansin ko ay yung issue namin sa pag-travel. Kasi issue to na mas makakamura sana kung yung travel namin ay ano sana yung piece of fare or whatever. Pero you know what, we were happy to have worked with the purchasing office para hindi namin ma-overlook yung issue ito. And generally hindi po talaga kami nahirapan na lahat po ng mga travels po namin ay dumadaan sa purchasing, no? So ang takeaway ko doon, it's really just a matter of developing a clear-cut action plan kung paano mo i-execute yung mga kailangan mong gawin para sa field work. And so we have gone around the country because of that. And so medyo interesting yon. And then also yung pagkuha ng cash advance, kailangan talaga matagal na time bago mo makuha. And it's really often na dapat maiwasan na natin na tayo ay nag-shell out ng pera. I really think malinaw dapat right from the start gaano katagal bago mo makuha yung pera para clear na hindi ka na talaga mag-aabon. Now, these are some of the issues later na pwede pa natin pag-usapan. So for now, I am happy to share with you. Ito na yung Excel file na medyo maganda siyang practice. Hindi siya liquidation lang. The grant means that ang ginagamit natin sa pag-spend ay hindi lang po yung salary natin, hindi lang po yung 30,000 grant, pero talaga or whatever it is na binibigay ng RCSED, meron po siya mga other things na kailangan i-include sa ating sa ating pong presentations, lalo na pagka i-report na natin siya. Nakatulong po ito nung dinevelop to ni Miss Ruth, and Miss Ruth, kindly explain sa Excel kung paano natin nababalanse ang ating mga pondo. Thank you.
Okay po.